In this video, we are going to talk about 10 beautiful places to see in South Dakota. So before starting this video, please like this video and subscribe to our channel for the future updates. Situated in the center of the country, South Dakota offers urban attractions and rugged natural beauty. From badlands jutting into the sky to national music museums, South Dakota offers several reasons to take a vacation. The outdoors is truly stunning in South Dakota and is what draws the most visitors. The Black Hills on the western side of the state define most outdoor adventures. Within these wooded acres, which supported indigenous populations for thousands of years, visitors find an array of attractions, including underground caves and larger-than-life monuments. As evident in the patriotic nature of monuments like Mount Rushmore, the landscapes of South Dakota also come with a unique history that adds to the experience of visiting. Other places to visit, like Deadwood, the Crazy Horse Memorial, and Good Earth State Park, also expand on the history of the region. Here's a list of the 10 beautiful places to see in South Dakota. Let's start. Number 10. Good Earth State Park at Blood Run. On the western side of the state and outskirts of Sioux Falls, Good Earth State Park has a deep history in the area despite its relatively new status as a state park. Good Earth State Park, as part of the larger Blood Run National Historic Landmark, occupies a lush area that once served as a thriving trading center and gathering places for the Oneota peoples. The site is currently regarded as one of the oldest areas of human history in the country. Visitors today can learn about the culture and history of the area through a newly installed 11,000 square foot visitor center. The park also maintains over 650 acres of native habitat, including interpretive trails that lead to the Big Sioux River. These allow visitors to experience the environment that has hosted these Native American people for thousands of years. Number 9. National Music Museum. The National Music Museum and AMP, Center for Study of the History of Musical Instruments at the University of South Dakota in Vermilion, features thousands of American, European, and non-Western instruments from all over the world. The museum also covers a wide range of historical periods. At this self-touted spot for music lovers, a small admission fee provides access to a wide variety of musical instruments, ranging from American electric guitars to German zithers. The museum features over 15,000 instruments on display. A 2021 expansion to the museum is set to add more space for the growing collection. Number 8. Spearfish Canyon. Spearfish Canyon is a beautiful natural area known for an abundance of ponderosa and spruce pine trees, as well as stunning waterfalls and dramatic cliff walls. Popular roadside attractions and hikes in Spearfish Canyon include Bridal Veil and the Rough Lock Falls, and the Spearfish Peak and Little Crow Peak. While any time of the year guarantees beautiful natural scenery along the 22-mile route, the entire area is particularly scenic in the fall, when the foliage begins to change color. Just north of Spearfish is the geographical center of the United States. The city of Spearfish, the northern terminus of Spearfish Canyon Scenic Byway, is a great base camp, with a lively community and several places to spend the night. Number 7. Deadwood. Dense Black Hills scenery surrounds Deadwood. And this blast from the past destination is steeped in the rich history of the Black Hills Gold Rush. Deadwood's Wild West origins are on full display and waiting to be experienced throughout the downtown streets. Some of the top attractions of Deadwood include reenacted shootouts on historic Main Street, the Adams Museum, and the Broken Boot Gold Mine. Another fun place to visit in Deadwood, the Mount Moriah Cemetery, is the final resting place for some of the biggest characters of the Wild West, including Wild Bill Hickok, who met his demise in a local Deadwood establishment. The city still has a touch of its wilder days, but much of the fun is centered towards families looking to enjoy a South Dakota vacation. Number 6. Mammoth Site. The Mammoth Site in Hot Springs features a large number of Columbian mammoth bones. More than 60 mammoths, including 3 woolly mammoths, have been discovered at this site. Visitors can see partially uncovered mammoth bones shown as they were found, in a covered, climate-controlled building. Guided tours are available, giving visitors a glimpse of the excavation process. Junior and advanced paleontology classes are available for anyone interested in getting their hands dirty. The on-site Ice Age exhibit hall displays some of the fossils being found underground. Number 5. Wind Cave National Park. Wind Cave National Park, located just north of Hot Springs, is home to a huge karstic cave system, thought to be among the largest in the world. It was discovered in 1881 by a hunter, who noticed a draft coming from a split in the rock. The cave contains a unique and delicate cave structure known as boxwork, which is found in few other places in the world. The only way to explore Wind Cave is through one of the many park ranger guided sightseeing tours that take place nearly every day of the year. Different tours are available for different ability levels, with most routes following along lighted and cement pathways installed by the Civilian Conservation Corps in the 1930s. Number 4. Crazy Horse Memorial. The Crazy Horse Memorial, north of Custer, has been a work in progress since it was begun in 1947. The head and upper body portion of revered Lakota leader Crazy Horse have been carved into this mountain, like the Mount Rushmore carvings just down the road. The on-site Indian Museum of North America enriches any visit to Crazy Horse. The museum grounds feature several visitor experiences, including the Native American Education and Cultural Center. Visitors can access scheduled bus rides to the base of the memorial throughout the day to meet Crazy Horse face to face. Number 3. Custer State Park. As one of the best state and national parks in South Dakota, Custer State Park covers a wide range of different terrain. A large herd of bison roams the peaceful landscape, which is also home to a wide variety of other wildlife. And granite peaks tower over the forests, lakes, and streams. Scenic drives, like the Needles Highway and Iron Mountain Road, provide easy access to the park with great views along the way. And several campgrounds within the park host visitors from around the world. For the more adventurous, there are trails for hiking, biking, and horseback riding. One must-travel route in Custer is the Sylvan Lakeshore Trail. This waterfront route leads around the rock-lined reservoir and has many side trails to explore. In the same area, hikers will also find the challenging trailhead leading up to Black Elk Peak, formerly known as Harney Peak, and the highest peak in the state. Number 2. Badlands National Park. The dramatic landscape of Badlands National Park consists of uniquely formed hills and pinnacles made from the erosion of clay and sand. A large herd of bison roams freely within the park, adding a unique element to the whole experience. This inhospitable scenery is strangely beautiful and one of South Dakota's most visited destinations. Lined with parking places and viewpoints, the Badlands Loop Road tours the scenic environment from the northwestern pinnacle's entrance to the Ben Rifle Visitor Center. Changing vistas of rugged rock formations are the real appeal of this scenic route, as well as the Buffalo Gap National Grassland, one of the last remaining intact prairie landscapes in North America. The Cedar Pass area is home to the park's 8 designated trails routes like the Door, Window, and Notch trails offer an easy hike into the challenging environment. Maps can be obtained from the park administration or from visitor centers. Number 1. Mount Rushmore National Monument. This historical monument is South Dakota's most prominent tourist attraction. Carved majestically into the side of the mountain are the heads of Presidents George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, Abraham Lincoln, and Theodore Roosevelt. The carving, designed by Gutzon, was begun in 1927, halted for several decades, and finally completed in 1991. In its creation, more than 400,000 tons of rock was blasted from the side of the mountain. The monument is illuminated in the evening and accompanied by a patriotic ceremony. What do you think of our video? Let me know in the comments section below. If you enjoy this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. Thanks for watching.